Hi, I'm Oscar van Deventer, and this is the overfunctional Siamese. It looks like it's a regular Siamese cube that is Tony Fisher style, having glued two by twos together into a puzzle. But this one is, as Mike Armbrust called it, fully functional, because after Mike's design, also the top layer turns. So this means that parts from the left and the right side can be switched, and we can have these turns. A problem with Mike Armbrust's design, and also Dave Peters and several other people who have designed this, is that the corners do not stay in place. However, for this puzzle, the overfunctional Siamese, the corners stay in place. You see, they are steady. Okay, I just cheated them a little bit out, but anyway, they are stay steady in place. And but when they're here, they turn quite well. So let me show you how the mechanism works. I'll first pop the cap. So here we are, orange cap off. And then let's remove a few pieces. So there we are, and here you can see the mechanism exposed, parts that fit into each other, and let's see when they go into each other. And well, the screw, you believe. When you see here, this little pin, and at the inside of each corner, there is a little hole. And when we make a turn, what you see is the pin comes out, and we turn even further, it turns in. So let's look at it sideways. When we turn, we see the pin come out, and when we turn back, the pin goes back in. So when you have a piece that's connected at the corner, so let's put one there, you see it stays, it now can turn, but when we make this rotation, it's locked by this pin mechanism. And in order to make the mechanism work, the whole mechanism is constructed of multiple parts. Bit hard to see. Here we have this elliptical part, and the ellipse, it turns in the grooves, and this ellipse turns into these grooves, so that is how all these pieces start moving and start going out. Here you see it again. So it's at both sides that the pin goes out and goes in again. So my question to you is about this mechanism. We have a mechanism with a pin that goes in and out, and it's quite useful for this twisty puzzle. And what other twisty puzzles can you come up with where such a mechanism would be useful? Thank you for watching.